Danny Segura for MMAJunkie.com here in New York City, next to Benson Henderson, former UFC champion, Bellator contender. You'll be taking on Michael Chandler on June 6th in Chicago. First of all, this fight was booked, the rematch, for December. It didn't happen. You suffered an injury.
Yes.
Can you kind of give us an update on what happened and how are you feeling now?
Yeah, I'm feeling a lot better now. Feeling 100% good to go. The injury was bad enough for where I wouldn't be able to train how I needed to train to be ready for the fight. Could I have fought? Yeah, maybe, but would I have been at 100% and ready to beat a caliber fighter as Michael Chandler? No, probably not. I felt like I would not have been. My last fight against Chandler, I had a fight on a torn ACL, had a torn ACL, torn MCL, two torn meniscus, and I still decided to fight anyways. And probably not the best decision, you know?
That's for the first one.
Yeah, for the first mm-hmm. one, you know, I fought on a torn ACL. So for this one, I was like, yeah, maybe I should be healthy. Okay. Maybe I should be, you know.
That's a good idea.
You're never like 100%. You always have nicks and bruises, but fighting with a torn ACL, fighting with a broken bone, probably wouldn't have been a smart thing to do, you know? So I decided to, you know, first time ever in my career, say, hey, I can't fight. I got an injury. Got to push it back a little ways. And thankfully, Bellator said, okay, cool, no big deal. We'll rematch you guys later on.
Yeah. First time ever pulling out of a fight?
First time ever for me to pull out of a fight because of injury. In 14 years, I've been doing this. That was the first time ever. Ooh, it burns me up inside.
Yeah, I was going to ask you, was that a hard decision to, like, you know, make the phone call?
Super hard, super hard.
How'd it go down?
My wife had to talk me into it. She's like, yeah, she said, yeah, you're not fighting. Yeah, no, broken fighting with broken bones is not a good idea. I was like, okay.
Yeah. So you mentioned those issues going into the first one, and you still, you know, took them to a split decision. Some people thought you won. Does that give you any confidence entering the rematch, knowing that you weren't 100% and you still managed to, you know, put on that kind of performance?
I wouldn't say that gives me confidence, but just, you know, everything. I'm a very confident person. Fighters are confident. They should be confident, you know. I'm perhaps as confident as any fighter on that stage. I'm a very confident individual. But yeah, I think going against Chandler, fighting him on you know, one ACL, knowing that I'm good to go and we'll be healthy going into our rematch, definitely gives me confidence for sure.
Yeah. And obviously this is a big fight. We just saw that Scott Coker at the presser said it was going to be a title eliminator. Did you know that going in, like, into the fight, or was that news for you?
It wasn't announced, it wasn't official, but hearing Scott talk about it makes me happy. I'm very glad to hear. There couldn't be sweeter words to my ears than that right there, knowing that is a title eliminator. And then, you know, stuff down the line, we've got to worry about Patricio, and he's tied up and this and that, and so can't be worried about that. Got to be worried about Chandler, facing it off against him, get my hand raised, putting him away, and then go on from there.
Yeah. So you and Chandler have only fought once, but, you know, if you beat him, obviously you'd be one apiece, could potentially set up a trilogy. Just wondering, how do you feel about Chandler as an opponent, and do you kind of have that in mind? Like, you know, I'm fighting him now, but I could potentially fight him again, you know, a third time.
Chandler, he can get it as many times as he wants to. If he wants to fight 10 times, that's no problem. But I'm going to win 9 of those 10 times. He got the first one. He gave it to him as a split decision. The next 9, I'll be putting him away. I'll be finishing him, looking for submissions, looking for the knockout. You know, his chin's not the same as it was early in his career. Early in his career, he was known as, you know, throwing hard and having a good chin and this and that. Now he doesn't throw quite as hard. Now his chin is a little bit more suspect, and he relies on his wrestling a lot more in his later fights. And I don't think he'll be able to rely on that against me and out wrestling me in our next fight.
Yeah. And, you know, your Bellator run at the very first wasn't maybe the best, but now you're what, 4-0 in your last four outings? Still, if I'm not mistaken, you've been looking good. I guess what's been the change, or was it maybe just a string of bad luck, or kind of what went on there, and how have you been feeling now?
No excuses, no bad luck. No, you know, I didn't change anything. There was no drastic change or whatever. I've been doing the same thing I've been doing my entire career. Sometimes you have good runs, sometimes you have bad runs. Sometimes, you know, this happens, that happens. A fight doesn't go your way. Andre Korshkov beat my butt, so that wasn't a bad call. That wasn't a bad decision. That wasn't nothing.
170, right?
Yeah, 170. Yeah, he just beat my butt for 25 minutes. I don't think I won a single minute of that fight. But the rest of my fights have, you know, gone my way, got my hand raised, got a couple of finishes in there as well, so that's good. But, you know, just stay on the grind, trusting the process, trusting yourself, believing in your gym, in your coaches, in your corner, and trusting in yourself that you're doing the right things.
Yeah. A couple more things. Obviously, you didn't lose the fight with Chandler because the rematch got booked in December, but you did lose the opportunity to fight in Japan then. Did that hurt? Is that something you have in mind, like potentially fighting in Ryzen and getting that experience?
I do love fighting in Japan. Yeah. I won a world title in Japan.
That's right.
And so I have a lot of fan base out there. And Japan is awesome.
You have Japanese descendants, right?
No, I'm half Korean.
Okay, Korean.
So right. Yeah. But I love fighting in Japan. It's an awesome experience. The fans are amazing. They're awesome. Super nice. Super polite. They always bring you gifts. Like, so you go to an event,
oh, really?
I'll leave with like a bag full of gifts. It blows my mind. Yeah. I'm like, you guys shouldn't be giving me gifts. Like, hey, thank you though. Awesome. I appreciate it.
What's the coolest thing you've gotten from a fan?
Some personalized. Everything is like personalized. But I'll have like a personalized whatever. Stationery or a stamp or something, but like with my name in Japanese, Benson Henderson, but in Japanese, and they say, oh, we got this for you, or you know, angel wings this or angel wings that. Like, I got some really cool stuff.
Yeah. Now, last thing, something I picked up at the press, or I might, you tell me if I'm, you know, this is a good read or not, but I felt like you maybe weren't enjoying the little banter they were having. You kind of called them out, like, if you're going to do something, all right, let's set up a fight.
Yeah.
And I know you've been vocal about, you know, how sometimes things go in the UFC. Wondering if that's accurate or not.
I don't like, you know, the little dogs barking. I don't like little dogs barking trying to get attention. Like, if you want to do it, you guys are grown men. Like, literally, you guys are staying in the same hotel. Go to the hotel and find out. There's the gym down the street. Just go to the gym and find out. There's no need to talk about it. I understand, though, you want to sell a fight. Cool. You know, no problem. But there's certain ways to go about it. You want attention. You want to be an actual big name. I mean, you could win your fight. You could do it impressively. You have a super big knockout. You could have a super cool submission. You can. There's other ways to go about it. But, you know, to each their own. Some guys prefer that. Some guys don't. You need all types of people to make the world go round. And, you know, I am a certain type of way. And some people are other certain type of ways. And some people enjoy that. Some people enjoy this.
Yeah.
You know, it is what it is.
Yeah. All right, Benson. Well, I appreciate the time. Yep. Best of luck against Chandler.
Thank you, man.
Thank you.